Our speaker today is the 50th Attorney General of the state of Texas. He was born in Wichita Falls, grew up in Duncanville. He is a graduate of University of Texas in Austin, and is a graduate of Vanderbilt Law School. He has worked hard as Attorney General. Prior to that, he had been a district judge in Harris County and had then served on the Texas Supreme Court. I've known Greg for a long time. He is a hard-charging lawyer, and he is not afraid to file cases when the odds are against him or the odds are in favor of him. And he works extremely hard at protecting the laws and enforcing the laws in the state of Texas. We're honored to have him. At this time, I present to you our Attorney General, Greg Abbott.
Well, thank you all, and Chancellor Hans, thank you for your very kind introduction. I got to tell you, the state is blessed to have had you lead the remarkable Texas Tech University system for all these years. Chancellor Hans, thank you for your service to Texas Tech University. I appreciate the warm hospitality shown by you, Chancellor Hans, as well as by the regents and all of these outstanding leaders of this incredible institution. Well, to the graduates of Texas Tech Law School, it's an honor to be with you on such an incredibly important day in your lives. All those late nights and early mornings have finally paid off. As I think of the mornings that you must have had as you prepared to take your finals and as you went through those final exams, I'm reminded of the graduation remarks of a famous boxer, George Foreman. He said that his problem in school was sleeping. If classes had started in the afternoon, he would be a college graduate today. Well, graduates, today you're surrounded by these people who stood between you and the snooze button, the moms, the dads, the grandparents, and the loved ones who saw to it that this day finally came. They raised you, they motivated you, they supported you from their hearts and their pockets, and we thank them all for what they have done to ensure this day is here. There's one thing that we know for sure, and that is that these family members of yours are extremely proud today. You cannot imagine the sense of joy that they are experiencing. So today would be a great day to ask for money. Well, in addition to the pride that you and your families have today, there may also be a sense of loss, a sense of sadness that you are leaving Texas Tech and law school forever. Well, let me assure you that you never really leave, because the Texas Tech Law School Fundraising Committee will be on your back until the day you die. The biggest laugh came from the guy who's in charge of it back here. Well, I'm going to try to keep my remarks brief. I know that we've been moving along at a pretty fast clip, but I learned firsthand the importance of being brief during my tenure as a justice on the Texas Supreme Court. One thing that Texas Supreme Court justices do is we travel around the state giving continuing legal education seminar presentations. And I was given a presentation like that one day to a large room full of lawyers. And I was the next speaker, and I pulled up through one of the doors in the back of the room and pulled up alongside a lawyer. And I kind of wanted to get a feel for how things were going, so I asked him how things were going. He said, well, things are going pretty good so far, but our next speaker is one of those long-winded judges, and you know how that goes. I said, well, do you have any idea who I am? He said, no, I have no clue. I said, well, I'm Judge Greg Abbott, and I'm the next speaker. We could tell he was embarrassed, but you could also tell he was a quick-witted lawyer because he looked right back at me and asked me if I had any idea who he was. I said, no, I have no clue. He said, great, I'm out of here. I know you want to get your degree and be out of here, so let me get to my point. Exactly 30 years ago this day, I sat right where you are sitting, on the threshold of law school graduation. I was ready to embark upon what I hoped would be an exciting career in the law. Frankly, at my graduation ceremony, I can't even remember who the speaker was or much about what was said. I do seem to vaguely recall some blah, blah advice about how the future would be filled with challenges. I didn't know at the time how prophetic the speaker would turn out to be. Because little did I know that the picture of me walking across the stage to receive my diploma for my law school degree would be the last picture of me walking. After graduating, I moved to Houston to join a law firm and begin my legal career. But I had one last test to take in life, the bar exam. I was studying for the bar exam and took a break, and I went out for a jog. And while I was out jogging, a huge oak tree crashed down onto my back, fractured my vertebrae into my spinal cord, leaving me immediately paralyzed and unable to ever walk again. Some of you are shaking your heads wondering, how slow was that guy jogging to get hit by a falling tree? Well, the months following my graduation from law school proved my speaker right. They were challenging. The future I had taken for granted was changed in an instant. Rather than developing legal skills, I had to relearn everyday skills. Opening doors, driving a car, reaching for items that were placed way high up on a shelf. But more important than those daily skills, I learned fundamental skills about life. I learned that you never know when a tree is going to come crashing down onto your back. I learned how precious life is and how it can forever change in a single instance. I realized that we are given the gift of life and we have the opportunity and the responsibility to use it. Well, as I worked my way through that challenge, eventually becoming a lawyer, becoming a judge, a Supreme Court justice, and now Attorney General, I found that our lives don't have to be defined by our circumstances. Instead, our lives can be determined by our character. I found that more important than the ability to walk is the path that we take in life. A life without walking is something that can be dealt with, but a life without principles cannot. So as you leave this wonderful school and go off into the world and chase your own dreams, there will be no guarantees, but there probably will be plenty of opportunities. Your law degree may not always take you down the predictable pathway. Your path and your legal career probably will, like mine, face many challenges. But those challenges don't determine your destiny. You do. Your lives are not defined by how you're challenged. Instead, you get to define your lives by the way that you respond to the challenges you face. Consider just one story. A story about a young girl who grew up in Houston. She was the fourth of seven children of immigrant parents from Monterrey, Mexico. Her father was a welder, her mother a cleaning woman. Both of them had only elementary school educations. Well, to help her family earn money, this young girl began working nights in a drapery factory at the age of 13. Though her parents didn't have wealth, power, or influence, they taught this young girl that ordinary people can do extraordinary things. And she did. She studied hard in high school and college, and then on into law school. This woman's name is Eva Guzman, and she is now the first Latina to serve as a justice on the Supreme Court of Texas. Clearly, there are many paths that your future can take as you leave this graduation ceremony tonight. Where your path may lead, whatever you may do after leaving here, in the end, it really doesn't matter whether or not you wind up rich or poor. It doesn't matter where you live or what you do for a living. It won't even matter whether or not you can walk. What will matter is the unique fingerprint that you leave on this world. Quite literally, your fingerprints are on every single thing you touch, like the programs you have in your hands right now. But more powerfully and figuratively, your fingerprints are on every person you've ever dealt with, on the school that you're leaving, on the family and friends that you've been involved with, and ultimately your life is measured by the fingerprints you leave behind. So as you leave here today, we look forward to watching the paths you take and the unique imprint you leave on this world. Congratulations to the class of 2014. May God bless you all, and may God continue to bless the great Texas Tech University system.